All right, dickheads, I'm your chunky messiah, Ethan, and I'm just here with a bit of an old impressions video. Yes, this time it's of Foundation on that there PC. Right, I always forget to clear my throat before I start recording. Anyway, so, for those of you who aren't aware, Foundation is a new game. It's just come out into Early Access, and by just came out, I mean it came out on February 1st into Early Access. It is developed and published by a company called Polymorph Games. This is the second time I've had to record this, because the first time I said polygraph, and if in case you don't know what a polygraph is, that's a lie detector test, which would make no sense for the company that developed this game. It's a company that, as far as I can tell, hasn't, as a studio, hasn't developed anything outside of Foundation, though wouldn't surprise me if various members of the development team have done other things in the past. There's a lot of studios like that around. I'm going to stop dodging around what the game is. This game, to put it incredibly bluntly, is a medieval-style city-building game. Yes, which very much caught my attention. Now, before we actually get into it, I am going to tell you that, as I said, it is Early Access. It's just freshly gone into Early Access, so it is in a very early state. So, do be aware, there's a lot, you know, this is the earliest version of the build you can really be seeing. You know, it's very, very early on. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you kind of a little bit of the way in. I haven't gotten a particularly solidly functioning settlement just yet, because I'm still kind of learning the game. I just wanted to get a video on this out as soon as possible, because spoilers, I quite like it. But yeah, so I'll show you the town I'm currently playing, Township Omega, in a bit. But first of all, let's just start ourselves a new game here. In fact, we're going to start it on the default here, balancing default, as if there's any other choice, and map hills. There are some other ones here, but we're going to go with hills, just because that's it's the default. And also because that's the same map that good old Township Omega is based out of. It seems that the maps are I'm saying seems as if I don't just know for a fact. But yeah, the maps are themselves all the same. And they're not all the same, sorry. That's just not even slightly what I meant to say. The maps are all static. They're not randomly generated, so you do have this thing. You do, though each map does have various kind of possibilities for you, because you can see here is that you do select one of various hexes to start in. I, on this map, almost exclusively start in this hex. So, I think that for Township Omega, I think I actually started in this hex and expanded over here. But we're going to start in this land. There you go. Free. We'll add nothing to our royal taxes. Okay, we got our city, our little territory, our little village started here. And the first thing we have to do is we have to plop down little village center, and immediately that spawns in our first crop of villagers. Who, let's just get this out of the way right now. Good God, they look evil. Like, they, like, universally all look like they want to, they do horrible things to you. Like, it's, I mean, it's a good thing that you're almost never going to be zoomed into this level, but Jesus H. Christ, they're a bit grim looking. So, a good way to describe this game, at least, and which is actually a way that I've seen it described by multiple people in Steam reviews and stuff already, is kind of Banished mixed with City Skylines, because, well, you can kind of see the Banished thing going on here. You got your little villagers here, got your little start off there, you got to put down some construction buildings, you know, some resource gathering buildings. However, the game also has zoning in the same way that something like City Skylines does, like with a more traditional city builder does, kind of a Sim City-ish approach, which I find very interesting. Currently, we've only got land that, I think Forbidden Land is just, yeah, nobody will walk on Lord's land, yeah. So Forbidden Land, they're not allowed to go there. An extraction allows woodcutting, stone cutting, and berry gathering. I've just realized, actually, why no one was working on one of my resource buildings in Township Omega. I didn't put an extraction zone around something. That would actually explain quite a lot. But yeah, this is all we got so far. We're just going to mark all this lovely woodland here. Just this entire area. Actually, yeah, we'll just mark this entire quadrant there. And you know what? Try and make sharpen it a bit. There we go. And just cut that out there. Okay, so that's that. But yeah, it's got a lot of painting. You do later on, you get like farming and residential. It's a lot kind of, there is a lot more micromanaging than you'd necessarily get with something like City Skylines, but it is interesting to see this kind of combination of direct building placement and very kind of micromanaged zoning going on there. And also as well, because we also have to have direct control over all of our villagers, which again, very banished. The UI is a little bit, it's almost a little bit Parkitect to me, a little bit Rollercoaster Tycoon, because everything opens like little windows like this that you have to manually click close. There's like a little bit of a kind of an older PC aesthetic going on there. But I'm gonna stop fucking wittering on about that constantly now. Let's actually start putting down some construction buildings. As you can see there, placement, the trees will vanish if you're gonna replace, if you need to replace something. Let's also get a stone cutter put there. Let's get a gathering hut over there, and let's screw it, yeah, put a well there. We're gonna need a well at some point. I'm not sure what we need it for, but we're gonna need a well at some point. And you know what, we will also actually get the sawmill sorted out over here as well. Let's put it that way. There we go. And now, just as is necessary, tell absolutely everyone to be a builder until everything has been constructed. Thankfully, we do, as you can see, we do start with certain, with a certain array of resources, so we can get started. So let's just, with all that done, let's just hit the double time there, and yeah, they will all run off and start constructing things, while everyone else just kind of stands around, doesn't get much done. You may notice actually that we've got walls here, no walls unlocked. I don't even think there's walls in the game yet, though. I can't think of what walls are for. I imagine they'd be largely decorative, because as far as I know, there isn't any combat in the game. But you may have noticed a distinct lack of anything road-like, and you may have also noticed that there's like a little dirt path seems to be left, almost like a fucking snail trail, wherever the peasants go. Kind of an interesting little layout there. That's something I quite enjoy. I remember when I first got review code of this game, I was talking to my friend Lara, because she's, you know, she's interested in this kind of game. She's interested in city builders, especially this caught her eye, because it, well, because as I said, it reminded her of, it reminded her so much of Banished, as it seems to remind a lot of people of Banished. So she was quite interested, but she was like, what, you can't build your own roads? And that was like, a slight point of contention between myself and herself. Like, you know, actually not between us, but for us. Was like, well, we want to be it's weird, we don't, like, it seemed to imply some bad things. But when we realized how the roads actually work, we were immediately just sold. Like, the second we realized what was actually going on. In case it's not clear, the way that the roads work is, well, everyone does kind of leave a slight trail whenever they walk anywhere, but which will kind of degrade over time. But the more a particular pathway is used, you can see it happening already, the more constant, I suppose, and the more permanent the bit of road, that bit of path that they left behind goes. So, you know, say, yeah, because the people from the gathering hut are going to constantly be going back and forth from the village center, same with the stonecutter, same with the woodcutter. These roads are going to become pretty permanent in time, because they're just going to be kind of reinforced by this constant back and forth from the production buildings, from the gathering buildings, and the stockpile here. Whereas, say, something like this little road here might not necessarily hang around anywhere near as much, because that little building there, that little road there, is, I didn't mean to hit wooden bridge. Because that little building that I meant to hit market. Because that little road there is, it's a construction path. That's all that is. Like, that's just what that's for. So, yeah, it makes sense that that won't necessarily stay there, because there's no real reason for it to stay there once the actual entrances have been established. So, you know, that's going to go away. And that honestly makes this game look aesthetically, it makes the layout, it might look a bit ugly immediately and while you're setting up, but it makes the villages look very nice. It connects them in a very sensible way, because in a lot of cases, these kind of lanes, those kind of pathways that later become more formal, did come into being because of that. Like, they came into being because it was just a path a lot of people walked, wearing away the natural growth there, and then later it was paved when it became a formal pathway. There's actually a route, a completely unpaved route, that is explicitly just that. Like, in my town, near my house, that basically connects our town and the one next to it. No formal path there, it's just a gap where people going from one to the next have always gone through in that way. It's pretty good. Okay, let's just get a market tender there, and I think get a carpenter, because we've got, I think everything we need built is built right now. Yep, everything we need built has been built right now, and oh no, that path is actually going to stay. No, that path is going to stay permanent, because the carpenter has to collect the wood from there and go into there. Okay, cool. So that path is going to be nice and sorted out. We're also making some money here. Money, that's an issue. I do not understand how the money system, I don't understand how to make money in this game. That's something I'm still currently learning. Okay, so this is, as it were, the, yeah, sure. This is, I'm going to pause it here. This is, as you could probably tell, this is the most bare bones and basic form of your village. You know, you got stone getting here, you got some wood, you got planks being made, and you got some food. Very simple. However, once people get past a certain degree of vileness, they obviously are gonna start wanting the finer things in life. You know, they're gonna want to start having a home in which to live and breed and sleep. I don't know if things breed. I don't know if people breed in this game. As far as I can tell, they don't. At the moment, that may be a thing that comes in later on. But as far as I can tell, currently, immigration is the only way that you actually gain more folk for your village. Do we have people coming? Yeah, actually, that's a question. Okay, we have some more people showing up soon. Although we don't currently have any houses. But yeah, you might have seen there that I just put down residential, and the basic bare-bones houses have been set up, as you'd expect from a zoning thing. The houses have just kind of cropped up where people want their houses, generally in relation to, you know, where the residential sections are and where they work. At the moment, I will admit, actually, we don't currently have anyone working on the houses, but that's because I'm waiting for these new immigrants to show up, so I can just set them as builders. And just kind of leave them as builders, because something I realized, actually, is that it is very helpful, especially because you've got this, unless you actively tell the game to stop, you will have this semi-constant, this regular immigration, this regular population growth, and each house, I think, caters to two people. So it's helpful to have builders around always, because you'll forget, and then you'll have to awkwardly take someone off of another job to make them a builder. Do you know what I mean? Okay, so the immigrants are on their way. I do not know where they're coming from. They're coming from over here. That actually interesting thing. As people come in and leave from various things, because later on you can, you know, unlock trade routes. As people come and go from the village, you will also see these kind of longer roads that almost seem to act as like the main road, explaining how, from whence people come and to whence people leave. You know, you get your immigrants to walk around this road. Like, this road will gradually get more permanent as immigrants come through and follow that exact path. And only more so when traders start coming in, when we actually unlock trade routes. You get these really long roads that just lead to foreign territories, to foreign lands that you'll never see. Because it's somewhere out in the distance. Okay, so we got our two new unemployed people. Build some houses. You want to live here? Start earning your keep. And we've unlocked some more buildings, such as the stonemason hut, which is something we actually really want. So let's get a stonemason hut going there. Because that'll produce polished stone, which I cannot recall what it's used for, but it's probably nice to have. And you can see here, you know, we're getting built here. You know, you can see already, this is like a fairly, at the moment, because of kind of the relative lack of things, because it is early access, it's a relatively simplistic, or a relatively bare bones in terms of features. A city builder at the moment. But, you know, it's a promising start. Do you know what I mean? And yet one villager lacks housing. Well, there's a lot of land here. Is there a lot of land? Yeah, there's loads of space where he could be putting his house. So, who is it? He's lacking for housing. Because there is loads of space. This is something, I think that sometimes they don't want to build their houses in certain areas. And you kind of need to wait for them to suck it up. But, it's a fairly good kind of base for what I hope to be a very good city builder. I remember I was talking with my friend Lara about it a couple of days ago, and it was a good sign, because what ended up happening with me is I was talking to her, I was doing something else, I was supposed to be playing WoW, you know, because I'm trying to level an alliance character up to max level, so I can, basically, so I've got an number one on alliance main and number two, so I can unlock the Kul'tirans when they come out. Because right now I do not have an alliance main. I do have Dark Iron Dwarves somehow, but I do not have an alliance main. But yeah, so I needed to do that, and I got this and I installed it basically just to test it, was my plan. And I just ended up sitting there, just doing it, just playing the game. I was just sat playing the game, just enjoying myself for like a while. It was kind of silly that I just ended up kind of sat here. When I was supposed to be doing something else. Like, I found myself getting sucked into it, because the game, at its very core, this game has some pretty enjoyable, pretty engaging, city-building mechanics here, you know. It looks good, it feels very nice, actually, just seeing the village kind of, behaving, seeing people going about their daily life. It's kind of a Zen game in the same way that Banished was, and that there is just something very appealing, at the very least to me and to other people who play this kind of thing, about seeing a village with these, you know, little living, these little, you know, AI-controlled people going around, living, doing their day-to-day, you know, doing things, working, being productive. There's something very nice about it, something very soothing about it. Okay, so before we go, because I think I've said everything I need to say aside from just repeating myself, I'm going to abandon that, because, doesn't matter, and we're gonna go and have a look at Township Omega, which is the town I'm currently working on, and the town that I'm desperately trying to figure out how to make money on, because, I don't know how long I've been playing this, actually, I don't know how long I've played this, a couple of hours, I think, and this is, where I am with this town, and yeah, as you can see, I lose money quite a lot. I do not, this is the system. If this game does have an issue in that it does very much leave you on its own, it does have some bugs, it does leave you on your own to figure out how the game actually works, which is causing me some issues because I cannot work out the fucking economy in this game. Like, I'm trading stuff to another town and all this nonsense, and I've got it's kind of advanced buildings, but I'm still pissing money. Like, it's not great. I'm also running out of food, which isn't fantastic, because I'm like halfway through making a change. Actually, I'm the first third of the way of making it, of the production of the chain. Let's reset. The production of the chain to create bread, because I need to build a... Because I've got, you know, you can see I've got more stuff. I've got reforestation over here to kind of maintain our woodland realm. But I've also got... Yep, this is why I'm not making any food. It's because I've not marked these for extraction. Yep, that's what I was talking about earlier, is that I realised that my fucking stone cutters, I've got 5 stone cutters here who never seem to be here, and I've got, 2 foragers there and 1 over there that never seem to be here, and it's because they're going to, like, yeah, they're going to this bush, like, in order to forage, instead of actually, now they're actually foraging and cutting stone in the place where they actually fucking work. By their actual territory there, but yeah. I'm like partway through the situation of farming and of trying to make bread, which would solve so many of my problems, but I just can't figure it out. Okay, I'm also some bugs, because for some reason, you can see this has just kind of been left on its own. The reason for that is I had stone cutters here, but past a certain point, my stone cutter camp just broke here, and they just kind of were frozen, not doing anything here for some reason. I've also slightly ballsed this up, because the people who are working up here The gatherers not so much, but the stonecutters who work up here live all the way down here, so they're not really getting much done. Thankfully, we've got a lot of stone anyway, but yeah. Current problems. Game's got a few bugs. The game doesn't have a tutorial to really explain how it works. Most of its core mechanics aren't too difficult to understand, but this economy is destroying me, and I can't wrap my head around it. But honestly, these are things that, while they're not great, they're not ideal. They are basically expected in a game this early into early access, and I'm sure that these are issues that will get rectified later on as the game develops. Because this is exactly what I hope for, really. What I would realistically hope for from an early access game. Because this, I've enjoyed playing it so far. I'm still trying to work out how the game itself plays. There's enough here that I can't remember how much it costs. I think it's like 20, 26 quid, something like that. Which is a bit pricey for an early access game, I will say that. Generally, I'm a bit wary of... Okay, apparently I've got more unlockables. Sure. Stonebridge. Okay. Because I haven't seen everything the game offers. This is kind of exactly what you want from an early access game. This is a strong foundation. It's got some problems. It's rough around the edges. And it's not as accessible as you'd necessarily like because of some of those, you know, those missing features. No tutorial, no campaign. There's very obvious gaps where things are intended to be. I mean, for fuck's sake. There's clearly just no walls in the game. It's weird to me that fucking buttons even there, since there's obviously no walls in the game as of yet. And there's also, like, a reputation system? Yeah, you can, like, get reputation with the clergy and the kingdom and labor, but I don't actually know what any of that means or if that does actually do anything. Yet it could very well be that those are very early tracking of stats that currently has no impact on the game, because it's just not that early, it's just too early into development for that to actually be there. But it's like the threadbare, the kind of the sign where mechanics will later be. As a starting point, this is really good. I enjoy it, like, already. I have fun playing this. So I can only think, it's already pretty good. Despite all the, you know, all the, it's rough around the edges, it's kind of buggy nature, and the fact that it's difficult to understand at times. I already really like this. I'm already a big fan. Then again, it is kind of it's almost pandering to me, do you know what I mean? Like, of course I like it, look at it, you know what I mean? But, yeah, I enjoy it. It looks like it, I'm hopeful for how this is going to turn out as it goes through early access. This is definitely not going to be the only time I talk about this game. I am almost certain to talk about this many times over its development as it improves, and I'm very excited to see how this game looks when it's completed, when it's finished. I'm really excited to see the state this game ends up in, and yeah, I feel like I'm gonna be responding to every kind of new content update that comes out for this game with excitement, you know, which is almost kind of what it's, yeah, it's one of those things, it's one of the good things about early access, kind of, is when you just find yourself excited. Like, RimWorld was like that for me, until that came out, where every time there was a content update, you were like, what's new? Like, what's been added? You know, I feel like this game is going to give me that as well, as long as it's supported well enough. It looks like it's going to be really good, really good. Because of its price, I'm not sure if I can recommend picking it up at this point. I feel like it'll be worth that price. Later on when it's more fully featured, but at this very early stage of the game, I'm not sure I can recommend it for that price. But then again, my view, as I say, I'm really enjoying it, but I am aware that my view on how much value a game really has when I got it for free is a bit, is a bit skewed. Looks really good. Looks like it's gonna turn out great. I'm hopeful for it. I'm excited to see where it goes. If you want to see it on Steam, there's going to be a link in the description to where you can pick this up on Steam, if you're interested. There will also be a link to the website for the game, which is slightly peculiar, but it's something the devs asked me to do, to put a link to the game's website, and Like, fuck it. You know, I like the game, so sure. If it was a game I didn't like, fuck 'em. But, like, I enjoy the game. Like, I'm excited about this game. So, sure, I'll put a link to their website. Yeah. Looks like it's pretty good. But that... I think we're done here. Bye. Well, I hope you enjoyed that. I might not have, but then that's kind of irrelevant. I'd make the stuff, not watch it. Anyway, big thanks to the names that are and have been scrolling across the screen. Their donations to my Patreon campaign are a huge help to me and the channel. If you'd also like to have your name listed here, follow the link in the description to find my Patreon page. There are rewards and such. Down there you'll also find links to my Twitter, Twitch, and the channel's Discord server. Stuff often occurs in one or indeed all of those places, so go have a look. And if you want more content, I upload basically a video a day. Right, I'm out of time. Bye.